हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज रज़ा मसूद। टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट अ टॉपिक प्रॉम्प्ट लिस्ट। फ्रेंड, लेट मी टेल यू दैट दिस इज़ अ टॉपिक विच डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट और प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड इन प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट इट्स अ टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू रिस्क और रिस्क मैनेजमेंट। सो फ्रेंड, एज पर द डेफिनेशन और एज पर द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ पिम्बॉक प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज, दिस इज़ अ न्यू टॉपिक विद रिस्पेक्ट न्यू टॉपिक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द PMBOK, Project Management Body of Knowledge. So, friend, with respect to exam point of view, if you are studying project management in university or you are planning to give exam of PMP, so this is a new topic and this is an important topic and you will see this topic in the exam. You can say around 3 to 4 questions are definitely expected, which are directly related to prompt list options, prompt list concept. Friend, if you are a professional project manager and you are already working as a professional project manager in any organization, so this is very important that you must know that what is prompt list, what is its importance and what is its implications in the practical life of a project manager. So let us start, friend. First of all, I would request to please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell option as well so that my new videos can reach to you. So let's start. Prompt list. Friend, first of all, prompt list, this video, this topic is directly related to project management. First of all, we have to understand what is the concept of project basically. If you can understand the concept of project, so we can move forward accordingly. First of all, try to understand the concept of a project. So friend, do you know really about the what is a project as per the definition of PMBOK? Friend, project is a temporary activity which has beginning and ending and it gives you a unique output, result or product. That is called as the project. For example, if you are implementing an e-commerce solution for a customer and you have to complete that project within 4 months, and after 4 months the project will finish, the resources will release and there will be no more expenses on the project, and at the end of the project we give a unique output or result as e-commerce solution for a customer, to a customer. So friend, we will say that this is an example of a project. Why? Because see friend, it's temporary. Temporary means that it is not ongoing. After 4 months the project will finish, okay? So this is a temporary activity. Secondly, it gives you a unique output. This is not the case that you are always giving the same result or same output or same product. After finishing the 4 months efforts, you will give a unique output, unique result or product. So first of all, try to understand the concept of a project. Project is a temporary activity which has a beginning and ending, like it will start on some specific date and it will end on some specific date, and it gives you a unique output, product or result. That is called as a project. Now if you can understand the concept of a project, now try to understand. Prompt list is a topic which is basically related to risk. Mainly this is a topic of project management, and under the project management this is a topic related to risk. Now if you can understand the concept of a project, we can discuss about the topic of risk. What is a risk, friend? Friend, risk is the uncertain condition of a project for which you are not sure whether it will happen or not happen. Let me explain you. See, take an example. For example, if you are launching a marketing campaign for a customer and you have hired a new face or new model for a marketing campaign, and you are not sure whether after launching the marketing campaign people will like the new model or not. If people like the new model, it will become an opportunity for you and you will you will get boost for your marketing campaign. If your market, if people don't like your new model or new face, so it will become an issue for you, and it will give a negative impact on your marketing campaign for a customer. So friend, risk basically means that it's a uncertain condition in a project for which you are not sure whether it will happen or not happen. If it happen positively, it will become an opportunity for you. If it happen negatively, it will become an issue for you. So remember friend one thing, that risk is not always a negative thing. Risk can be positive or can be negative. If it has a positive impact on a project, it will be a opportunity for you. If it is having a negative impact on your project, it will become an issue for you. Okay, so risk is the uncertain condition of a project which has a positive impact, which can have a positive impact or which can have negative impact. Okay, now prompt list. What is basically the prompt list? Main topic is prompt list. Risk prompt list is a predetermined list of risk categories that might give rise to individual project risk and that could act as a source of overall project risk. See friend here, first of all, here is the term risk category. Risk category means friend the grouping of risk. For example, like you can create categories for risk. For example, if you are implementing a project, so all the risks related to scope you can categorize at scope risk. All the risks which are related to procurement you can categorize at procurement risk. So risk category means friend that you can categorize the risk, you can grouping of risk, basically called as risk category. You can use any Excel sheet or Microsoft Word, so you can maintain the risk which you are identifying in your project. So categorize it with respect, categorize means that you can make a group of those risks. Okay, now friend, what does it mean by prompt list? Friend, prompt list is a predetermined list. Like you have already make a list of risk categories. Risk categories means that grouping of risk, and that might give rise to individual project risk and that could also act as a source of overall project risk. What does that mean friend? Friend, see, when you are starting a project, what you can do, you can already make a predetermined list of risk categories, and if there is any event occur like which are related to that particular category, so it can, you can say it will become a prompt for you. Basically what does it mean actually? See, take an example. For example, you are implementing an e-commerce solution and you have identified that risk category already predetermined from your past experiences. You know that if the cost of a project increase $500, so that means that e-commerce solution implementation is having trouble or is having problem. Just take an example. Okay, not going into the detail, just take an example that you have already predetermined list. You already know from your past experiences that you know that if the cost of a project increased by $500, so that means that there is a problem. Okay, so risk category, what is risk category? Risk category is cost here. So it will be a prompt for you. Why? Because you know from your past experiences that if the risk category, if the cost expenses are more than $500, that means project is off track. So you can take the corrective action accordingly, and it will act as a prompt list for you. So are you getting my point? Basically what I want to say, basically friend, just take another example. Prompt list is a checklist with a category of risk. Category of risk means the grouping of risk. This tool is a simple series of broad risks such as environmental or legal, rather than specific risks like flooding or regulatory changes. Friend, see, if you are implementing a project, so you can maintain a list of risk categories, predetermined list, like any risk related to legal or environmental, and it will act as a prompt for you. Like for example, if there is any changes like any changes related to legal, so you know from your predetermined list of risk categories that if there is any specific changes related to that particular legal contract, so it will be a risk for you. So if you just see that document, you can easily know that okay, this will become a risk for you if there is any change in legal, if there is any change in environmental. Okay, so that will be called as a prompt list. Okay friend, that is called as the concept of prompt list. Basically, prompt list means friend that you just make a list of predetermined risk categories means grouping of risk. Like for example, you can take an example of environmental or legal. If there is any change in the take an example that if there is any change in the legal, so it will be a prompt for you. From your past experiences, you know that if there is any particular change in the legal contract or if there is any change in the environmental, so it will be a prompt for you, it will be a risk for you. So basically, we maintain our list of risk categories in, you can say, in Excel or Microsoft Word, and whenever you found something, so it will be a prompt for you based on your past experiences, past knowledge. When you review that particular document of risk categories, so it will act as a prompt for you. So friend, thank you, thanks a lot for your time, and that's all from my side. I hope you like this video. If you like, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and thank you, thanks a lot for your time.